Hi there, Carrie here. In this video, we are going to talk about what to do about those parts of your assignment that are highlighted in the Turnitin Originality Report. If you missed it, the previous video, Understanding Turnitin's Report, covers how the similarity index is calculated and how the Originality Report is used to check for plagiarism. In this video, we'll discuss reviewing your matches and deciding what action to take, and how to plan your work to prevent plagiarism. So, you might be asking, what should I do now that I have reviewed the Originality Report for my assignment? To some extent, that depends on whether you have the option to resubmit your work before the due date. If resubmission is allowed, you should spend some time correcting any issues that might lead to an accusation of plagiarism. The first step would be to review each passage of text that is highlighted. If you are comfortable that the identified match is an innocent match, meaning it is something that will be common to other student submissions, like the headings provided by your instructor, or a restating of the assignment question, or it is a standard phrase specific to your discipline, then you can put that match aside and move on to the next match. If the highlighted text is a direct quote, make sure that you have used the quotation character at the beginning and the end of the passage of text. On a standard keyboard, the quotation character is on the same key as the apostrophe. Make sure that it matches the original source exactly, and remember to include an in-text citation and the full source details in the reference list. Quotes may be highlighted in the Turnitin report depending on the assignment settings. But if you've quoted correctly, you can put these matches aside and move on to the next match. If you see a match that indicates that you have indeed copied the text from a source, then you should consider rewriting that passage to paraphrase the ideas in your own words. Don't be tempted to substitute a few words here and there. The passage of text will often still be highlighted by Turnitin, since the original sentence structure remains the same. For more information on paraphrasing, check out Section 3.1.3 of the Academic Integrity at Curtin Student Guidelines for Avoiding Plagiarism booklet, which includes a step-by-step procedure to follow when paraphrasing. It is also generally a good idea to keep records of the sources you have consulted when researching for an assignment. Check out these websites for some tips on how to stay organized when researching your topic. There are also tools to help you find sources and to organize the referencing details for each source. Many also have options to let you add notes, such as summarizing the key points or paraphrasing passages of text from each source. And obviously, it's better to paraphrase relevant sources during this research phase rather than being tempted to just copy and paste. Finally, for each passage of text that you have paraphrased, go back and make sure that you have included an in-text citation and include the full source details in a reference list or bibliography. Planning ahead is a crucial skill to prevent you from facing last-minute pressures and temptations to take shortcuts. This includes checking early to see if you have the option to resubmit your work after you have reviewed the originality report. You should also be aware that Turnitin will only generate one originality report per day. That is, you won't be able to view a new report for 24 hours after you resubmit. So, if you want to check that your edits have addressed the text matching issues, you need to get your draft submission in at least one day before the due date. And while you're thinking about planning your submission, don't forget to download or print your digital receipt as proof of submission. Refer to the video, Getting Started with Turnitin, for information on how to do this. One last tip about planning. Before you submit your final draft for marking, you might find it helpful to use this checklist. The checklist and further information about Turnitin, plagiarism, and academic integrity is available on Curtin's Academic Integrity website. You can easily access the website from inside Blackboard using this tab, which is always displayed regardless of where you navigate to in your units.